Hi, I'm Mark Boyer, the Public Information Officer for New Hanover County, and I'm here at the New Hanover County Health Department with our Deputy Health Director, Joshua Swift. The big topic in the last few days, last couple of weeks now, is the radiation leak from the nuclear power plants in Japan, and what effect, if at all, there would be any effect here in North Carolina and in the Wilmington area. A lot of folks have already requested the potassium iodide pills, which may or may not protect a person to a degree in case of a radiological accident. So Joshua, tell us about KI, potassium iodide. Why should a person take it, if they should?
Well, basically, like I said, KI is potassium iodide. And potassium iodide, it protects your thyroid from radiation. Mm-hmm. So the potassium iodide goes into the thyroid and blocks the absorption of radiation. It's only protective short term. It's not a preventive medication that you can mm-hmm. take now that will protect you against future nuclear events. It's what we tell people in this area, and what they've been telling people in Japan is, after the event, that's when they tell them to take the KI. Mm-hmm. So, and
it would only block absorption into the thyroid gland.
Yes.
Yeah. It's and nowhere else.
No. Basically, the steps that would be taken in the case of a nuclear event, and you're seeing this in Japan, is the emergency and public health officials advise people to evacuate if necessary. In some cases, they ask people to stay in their homes.
Mm-hmm. Shelter in place what we call it.
Yeah. Shelter in place. Then the other option along with that is to take the KI, mm-hmm. potassium iodide. So.
Part of New Hanover County is within what's called a 10-mile emergency planning zone for our closest nuclear power plant, and that's in the Southport area. The 10-mile zone is basically Pleasure Island and Seabreeze area of the southern part of the county. Those folks can get KI, or actually have received KI already.
Yes, last May, the health department distributed 3,600 doses mm-hmm. of KI to the population down there. We have, within the health department, 75,000 doses mm-hmm. of KI available. So there's an ample supply in the area, and the folks in the Carolina Beach, Fort Fisher, Pleasure Island area, should have that supply with instructions. And again, I say, they should not be taking it now. They should wait, if there were a disaster,
right,
to hear from public health and emergency officials.
And that's one of the things that New Hanover County and Brunswick County regularly drills on is nuclear accidents, a radiological spill. So as part of that, we do distribute the KI pills for folks within that 10-mile zone, which mm-hmm. is, the most dangerous zone. Mm-hmm. How long does a KI typically last on the shelf?
Well, the KI that was distributed last May has an expiration date of September 2014.
Okay.
So 3 to 4 years.
Okay.
At least.
And then in 3 or 4 years, we'll distribute it again to those folks in the southern part of the county?
Yes, the state supplies KI to all counties or areas that have people living within that emergency planning zone.
Okay. What would you suggest for people who, are concerned about what is going on in Japan right now? It's a long way from southeast North Carolina.
Yeah. Well, I mean, there's no danger in southeast North Carolina from what's occurring in Japan. I think with any kind of emergency, whether it be hurricane or something like this nuclear accident, is staying informed, mm-hmm. listening to your local radio and TV stations. If you live in that emergency planning zone, making sure you have KI available, mm-hmm. and just staying informed.
And within that 10-mile zone, there's also the warning sirens that are, yes, that are tested a couple of times a year. So you'll definitely want to be aware of what that noise would be in case of something happening in Southport.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so again, we're just wanted to remind folks that here in southeastern North Carolina, there's really no big danger from the radiation leak in Japan.
No.
and there's no need to worry about your supply of potassium iodide?
No, not at all. It's you know, when we gave that potassium iodide in May, we gave two doses per person.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you see on the news where people are stockpiling doses of KI, and, you know, that's not appropriate. That's not necessary.
Right. Okay. So I guess the big thing for folks to remember then is just to be prepared and stay aware of what's going on by, you know, staying in tune to area media and New Hanover County TV.
Yes, that's right.
Okay. Great. Thanks a lot, Joshua. Appreciate your time.
Thank you.